हेलो एवरीवन, अ वेरी वॉर्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू स्वा एजुकेशन. माई सेल्फ राधा, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फूड हैजार्ड ऑफ नेचुरल ओरिजिन दैट कैन बी एल्केलॉइड, फिनोलिक्स एंड अदर नेचुरल कंपाउंड्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आर टुडेज लेक्चर. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टारगेट दिस पोर्शन वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सी फूड टॉक्सिन, बायोजेनिक एमाइन, एल्केलोइन, फिनोलिक कंपाउंड, प्रोटीज इनहिबिटर एंड फाइटेट. सो व्हाट इज नेचुरल टॉक्सिन? नेचुरल टॉक्सिन्स आर केमिकल दैट आर नेचुरली प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. एज द नेम सजेस्ट, नेचुरल मीन्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म नेचुरली. दीज टॉक्सिन्स आर नॉट हार्मफुल टू द ऑर्गेनिज्म देमसेल्फ, बट दे मे बी टॉक्सिक टू अदर क्रिएचर इंक्लूडिंग ह्यूमन वेन इटन. मीन्स दीज टॉक्सिन्स आर नॉट हार्मफुल टू द ऑर्गेनिज्म हु प्रोड्यूस देम. दीज केमिकल्स आर नॉट हार्मफुल टू द प्रोड्यूसिंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, बट दीज केमिकल्स कैन बी टॉक्सिक टू अदर क्रिएचर लाइक ह्यूमन हु कंज्यूम और फीड अपॉन दैट. Natural toxins are chemicals that are naturally produced by organism. These toxins are not harmful to organism, but they may be toxic to other creature including human when eaten, and some plant have the capacity to naturally produce compound that are toxic to human consume. So few toxins that we are also called secondary metabolite who provide defense mechanism to the plant, provide defense against herbivore and pathogen to the plant. So these metabolites provide a defense mechanism to plant, but they are harmful to the herbivore and pathogen who feed upon that. For example, alkaloids, phenolic compound, glycoside, terpenoids. So these are several kind of secondary metabolites. First one is toxin in seafood. What are they? Toxin can be present in some shellfish and fish. These toxins are also called amnesic shellfish toxin, diarrheotic, neurotoxic, paralytic, ciguatoxin and histamine. So the toxin that can be present in fishes or produced by the fishes are toxins in seafood. Seafood toxins are scombroid poisoning, ciguatera fish poisoning, paralytic shellfish poisoning, neurotoxic poisoning and amnesic poisoning. What's the risk of these seafood toxins? These toxins can cause gastro or neurological illness. Means these toxins mainly target gastric or the stomach related problems and neuronal problems like amnesic, diarrheotic, neurotoxic, paralytic poisoning, ciguatera poisoning, histamine poisoning. Several illness can result in respiratory failure, paralysis or even death. Anyone can get ill from toxin, but children are more likely to be seriously or ill or die, especially from paralytic poisoning. Toxins are not destroyed by freezing or cooking. These are not the method by which we can destroy the toxins. So what are biogenic amines? Biogenic amines are a specific class of neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters released by neurons like acetylcholine, dopamine, epinephrine, that is also called adrenaline. And non-epinephrine. So biogenic amines are a specific class of neurotransmitter that are found in a variety of food, such as fish, meat, cheese, wine, and are made through human biosynthetic pathway. So the mode of production of these bioamines are biosynthetic pathways and also made by the gut microbiome. There are five known biogenic amines: dopamine, epinephrine, norepinephrine, histamine, and serotonin, which are formed by the decarboxylation of amino acid. What is the decarboxylation? Removal of carbon dioxide. Decarboxylation of amino acid or amination and transmination of aldehyde and ketones during standard metabolic process. So what we can say? We can say biogenic amines are neurotransmitters like dopamine, epinephrine, norepinephrine, histamine, serotonin that are found in varieties of food, example fish, meat, cheese and wine. And they are produced by various pathways, various processes like decarboxylation of amino acid and transamination of aldehyde and ketone. So what is the importance of biogenic amines? Biogenic amines are like norepinephrine, epinephrine and dopamine, collectively known as cacliomines. Histamine and serotonin, these are some biogenic amines. So most psychotic drugs selectively affect synthesis or degradation of one of these biogenic amines. So how they produce? By several kind of pathways, like by deamination, by transamination, decarboxylation. So tyrosine, when there is a precursor, that is tyrosine, and tyrosine decarboxylase enzyme convert into tyramine by decarboxylation or removal of carbon dioxide. Lysine convert into cadaverin by the help of lysine decarboxylase enzyme by decarboxylation. Ornithine convert into arginine, and arginine decarboxylase enzyme convert into agamatine, and agmanitase enzyme convert it into putrescine. So these are biological amines. Next one is protease inhibitor. So as the name suggests, protease means the main function of protease enzyme is to cleave peptide bond or proteins. For example, there is a chain of amino acid, and these amino acids are linked together by peptide bond. And these protease enzyme can degrade these peptide bond. So protease inhibitor are molecules that block the activity of protease and typically functions on class of protease with similar mechanism. Protease inhibitor can either be in the form of protein, peptide or small molecule. Naturally occurring protease inhibitor are usually protein or peptide. Protease inhibitor used in experimental studies or drug development are often synthetic peptide like or small molecule. Many different protease inhibitor are commercially available to use experimentally in both in vitro, means in laboratory, and in vivo, means in open environment, and during protein purification method. So these are protease inhibitors: PMSF, E64, aprotinin. Next one is phytic acid. Phytic acid is a natural antioxidant that is mainly found in grain, nut and seed. So phytic acid found naturally from grain, nut and seed. Food high in phytic acid include cereals, legumes and certain vegetables. So these food are high in phytic acid. Phytic acid, also known as IP6, phytate, inositol, hexaphosphate. What is phytic acid used for? What is the use of phytic acid? Phytic acid is an antioxidant. Antioxidant help to remove free radicals from cell body. Sulfitic acid is a type of natural antioxidant. What is the function of antioxidant? Remove free radicals. These are highly reactive byproduct of cellular metabolism. Free radical contribute to the development of certain diseases. Food containing phytic acid are nutrient dense. For most people, these food are important to include a healthy and well-balanced diet. So now we are going to target alkaloids and another one is phenolic compound. So these are also the food hazard that are natural in origin because they are produced by the plant as a defense mechanism, provide defense against herbivore and pathogen to plant. So these are secondary metabolite. Plant consist of primary and secondary metabolite, and primary metabolite are mainly used for the development of the plant. When we are talking about secondary metabolite, these provide defense against herbivory, biotic, abiotic stress condition and pathogen to the plant. They may be volatile compound, means in gaseous form, and produced when required. Secondary metabolite produced when required for the defense mechanism. And these serve as a signal to help the plant to survive in adverse condition. When there is a stress condition, at that time these secondary metabolites serve as a signal to help to the plant. So secondary metabolite consist of nitrogenous compound, means nitrogen containing compound, like alkaloids, non-protein amino acid, cyanogenic glycoside. So these are mainly alkaloids are nitrogen containing compound. Another one is phenolic acid. Phenolic acid are OH containing compound that consist of flavonoids that are anthocyanin, flavones and flavonoids. These are phenolic compounds. Next one is glycoside that consists of glycone, or we can say carbohydrate and non-carbohydrate moieties, and cyanogen glycosidase enzyme. Another one is tannin, and another one is terpene compound like isoprenoid compound, like geranyl diphosphate, farnesyl diphosphate. So these are terpene compounds. So main topic that we are going to discuss is alkaloids and about phenolic compound. So alkaloids are a type of secondary metabolites, and these are mainly nitrogen containing compound. And they gather from plant used by other insect for their own protection. And these include succinic acid pathway. Succinic acid pathway. And the precursor of alkaloids are ornithine, tryptophan, tyrosine, phenylalanine, histidine, aspartic acid, tropane, pyridoxine and indole. So what is succinic acid pathway? So in succinic acid pathway, erythrose 4-phosphate plus phosphoenol pyruvate convert into phenylalanine. That is a kind of amino acid. It's a substrate, and it convert into transcinnamic acid by the help of which enzyme? By the help of phenyl ammonia lyase enzyme. It convert phenylalanine into transcinnamic, and this transcinnamic convert into पैरा काउमेरिक कंपाउंड प्रेजेंट इन सेल वॉल एज वेल एज इट एक्ट एज अ प्रिकर्सर फॉर लिगनिन एंड दिस पैरा काउमेरिल कन्वर्ट इंटू कैल्कोन इट कन्वर्ट इंटू कैल्कोन बाय द हेल्प ऑफ कैल्कोन सिंथेज एंजाइम बाय द हेल्प ऑफ कैल्कोन सिंथेज एंजाइम एंड दिस कैल्कोन कन्वर्ट इंटू फ्लेविनोन्स आइसोफ्लेविनो टैनिन एंथोसाइनिन एटसेट्रा. सो दिस इज अ सिकमिक एसिड पाथवे दैट इज मेनली यूज फॉर इट्स मेनली यूज फॉर फिनोलिक कंपाउंड फिनोलिक दैट इज ओ एच कंटेनिंग कंपाउंड. अनदर वन इज एल्केलॉइड्स. एल्केलॉइड्स ऑल्सो फॉलो सिकेमिक एसिड पाथवे. फिनोलिक्स फॉलो सिकेमिक एसिड एंड मेलेनोलिक एसिड पाथवे एंड एल्केलॉइड ओनली फॉलो सिकेमिक एसिड पाथवे. सो दीज आर सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइट दैट प्रोवाइड डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म अगेंस्ट हर्बीवोरी और द अदर पैथोजन दैट अटैक ऑन द प्लांट. So today we discuss certain kind of food hazard from the natural origin like alkaloids, phenolic compound, phytate, seafood toxins. So I hope this lecture is very clear to all of you. So thank you so much everyone. If you find this video beneficial for you, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel for more such kind of videos. And if you have any query regarding this lecture, you can comment down below.